eDog Australia. I know it's been a while since I've done a live video, probably about 9 months now, but we're here, we're back. We're going to be doing these weekly, hopefully going on forward from here. We have today BarkTech Citronella collar. This is something that we do sell a lot of on the website, so I've got a lot of commonly asked questions. So I just wanted to run you through how it works, how to set it up, and what it's used for, essentially. So we'll start with the collar itself. This is what it looks like. Nice little unit. And this is one important piece. Looks like it might be quite simple, but the strap and how you run it. So the strap should be run around the front over the label here, not over the back. This is where the sensor is on the actual dog collar. And so if it's run over there, it can sort of stop it from going off when it's on the dog. Strap is fully adjustable, which is great. So as you can see, can fit a really small dog up to something with like maybe a 60 centimeter neck, which is brilliant. On the top, we have our little compartment for the battery. Another thing that we have happen occasionally is this little lid here might go on a bit wonky, but if you slide it in and it sits flush, very little chance of it popping off, which is great. Once the battery is in there firmly, all you gotta do is switch it on at the front. Don't point it towards your face because it will do a test spray. Ask me how I know, it will get you in the eye. There you go. To test it, you can actually just blow into the little sensor on the back of the collar. Really straightforward. Goes for it. If it works like that, you know it's good to go. Put it on your dog. In regards to how firm you need to put it on your dog, it doesn't matter too much. Not too firm, obviously. You want to be able to fit at least sort of two fingers underneath the strap, so it's not strangling the dog. It doesn't matter if it moves around a little bit, pretty easy to do. You can also cut off the strap if you do have a smaller dog. Just be careful when you do, make sure you sort of singe the ends here. If you don't, it sort of tends to fray, just makes that collar last a lot longer if you do singe it. That's the collar and how it works. This is an extremely good idea to get if you have a dog that's maybe a little bit more sensitive. You don't want to do something like a static collar for barking, but you are having that trouble while you are out at work. I know a lot of you are now going back to the office, which is wonderful, but our new fur babies that we've acquired over COVID potentially might be going a little bit bonkers with you not there, have a little bit of separation anxiety issues. So this is a really safe, humane way to keep them a bit more relaxed during the day. One common question we do get is this thing gonna spray in my dog's face? No. So it goes on the side of the neck here, and when it sprays, it's going out in front of the face. So away from the eyes and away from the nose. It is unpleasant enough that it's gonna stop the dog from barking, but it's never gonna harm the dog. So really handy little piece. I'll run you through just quickly how to refill it as well. Make sure you turn it off for this. Again, you don't want it accidentally going off while you are trying to refill it. I'll try and do this one on camera. Here's your bottle. Get about 200-300 sprays, I reckon, out of this one. And the batteries you'll get, depending how much your dog barks, probably, I don't know, at least 2 weeks to a month or so out of a single battery. And we sell them in packs of 10 for about $28, $30 or something like that. So pretty economical. Now there's a little fill nozzle over here. Just make sure the collar is sort of flat, usually on a nice flat surface, and the actual bottle is upside down, and you just push it in. I usually hold it for about 10 seconds or so, let it go, and it's full. Switch it back on. Someone's at the front door. Don't worry, the dog's not barking. They're wearing a Citronella collar, so it's all good. If you blow onto the back of here, there you go, you test it, pop it on the dog, done. Now, I do also get a few questions around how to introduce this to the dog. It's a very good idea not to, especially on the first few occasions, wave the collar and strap in their face and then put it on the dog and switch it on. If you do this, the dog is immediately going to know when I'm wearing that collar, I'll behave myself, and when I'm not, then I'll just do whatever I like. So it's a good idea to gently introduce this to the dog, perhaps for the first maybe 2-3 days you have it on the dog but not switched on. On the fourth day, switch it on. Fifth day off, something like that. Try and trick them and just introduce it to them without making much of a fuss. That way you'll correct the behavior and not have to be wearing a collar for the rest of the dog's life. I've got a few questions written down here, so I'm just going to quickly have a look at those. So I do have a lot of questions. I think I mentioned it earlier around, will this actually fit my dog? I think it will work for any dog around about 4 to 5 kilos, up to sort of 60 kilos, depending on the neck size. As I mentioned, this is about a 60 centimeter strap, so very versatile like that. Will it work on a stubborn dog? Yes, it does. You'd be surprised at how many times I get a bull mastiff or something like that that is barking, and the owners think they're the most stubborn dog in the world, but a citronella collar is actually all they need to help relax during the day while you're out. So brilliant like that. I mentioned the one already. Will it spray my dog's face? No, it's going to spray out in front of their nose, in front of their eyes, and not get anywhere near that area. Also, I already mentioned how long it will last. So we get about 200-300 sprays in the bottle. The battery itself should get us about a month or so of use, but we sell them pretty cheap here at eDog Australia, being only about $28 for 10. It's really economical way. And that's it, actually. I think I've gone through just about everything. Thank you so much for tuning in. I know it's been a long time. And if you've got any comments, questions, you can get through to us on our website, edogaustralia.com.au. You can call us on the website as well. You might have already spoken to me over the phone. And we will see you in the next one. Thank you very much.